find the value of the square root of 81,225 using the prime factorization method and the long division method. So now the prime factorization method is familiar to you. We have two ways of finding the square root of a number. One is the prime factorization, which is known to you. The other is the long division method. So how do we find the square root of the given number by the prime factorization method? First, write up the number like this, 81,225. Check if this number is divisible by 2. It is not. So then we go with 3. Continuing, we go with 5 and then 19. So now 81,225 is equal to, see, 3 squared into 5 squared into 19 squared. 81,225 is 3 squared into 5 squared into 19 squared. Now what do we do? Take square root on both the sides. So on taking square root on both the sides, we have square root of 81,225 is equal to the square root of 3 squared into 5 squared into 19 squared. Write out this as it is equal to, we need to get rid of the square root symbol. We need to remove the square root symbol. How will that happen? From 2 3's, bring 1 3 out. From 2 5's, 1 5 out. From 2 19's, 1 19 out. Now this product is 285. So the square root of 81,225 is 285. Now let's understand how to find the square root of the same number using the long division method. Remember that you have to use only these products while using the long division method. What is this? 1 into 1, 1, 2 2's are 4, so these are square numbers. 3 3's are 9, 4 4's are 16, 9 9's are 81, 10 10's are 100. So you can see only square numbers here. In fact, you cannot use this. So up to 9 9's are 81. Let's start. So first write out the number in this format. Now, pair the digits from behind. Pair the digits from behind. So see here, 2, 5 makes a pair. 1, 2 makes a pair. And 8 stands alone. I repeat. 2, 5 forms a pair. 1, 2 forms a pair. 8 stands alone. We have to group from behind. 2, 5, so from behind, so these two, 2, 5, 1, 2, 8 stands alone. Now, we need to find this number 8 in the products available here. Do you find 8 here? No. Then which is that number which is just less than 8? Just less than 8, immediately less than 8 is 4. 4 is the number here which is just less than 8. So what is it? 2, 2's are 4. How do you use it here? See here? 2, 2's are 4. Subtract. 8 is a digit, 8 is the first digit available to us. 2, 2's are 4. We don't have 8 there. So the number which is just less than 8 is 4. 2, 2's are 4. Subtract. 8 minus 4 is 4. Now bring the next pair down. So 1, 2 comes down. Next, double the quotient, meaning multiply this by 2, double it. Double the quotient, multiply that by 2. So 2 2's are 4. Now, whatever digit you place here, you must place the same digit here. You have to place a digit here and you must place the same digit here. So it's going to be like this. Suppose you say 1 here, then it's going to be 41 into 1. 41 into 1. What's the product? 41 into 1 is 41. We need to get this number 412 or a number which is just less than 412. Alright? So this is too small. The number here is 412. This is too small. So say we try 44 into 40, 44 into 4. I said when you place a digit here, you must place the same digit here. Then what is the product going to be? 44 into 4. So what is 44 into 4? 176. No, but this number is 412. So we'll try to move ahead. We'll take a bigger digit. Say we take 7. Say we take 7. So if you place 7 here, you must place the same digit 7 here. And what will be the product like? 47 into 7. What is 47 into 7? 7 7 is 49. 4 carried over. 7 4 is 20. be 48 into 8. What is this? 8 into 64, 6 carry over, 8 for the 32, 38. Okay, we're getting close to 412. Let's try 49 into 9. So this is 9 for the 36, 44. Oh no, this is going beyond 412. 49 into 9 is more than 412. So we go with 48 into 8, which means you have to write an 8 here. See, 48 into 8. I said whichever digit you place here, you must place the same digit here. So 8 is a digit. 48 into 8. What's the product? 384. 384. Subtract. 12 minus 4, 8, 2. And now bring the next pair down. Bring the next pair down. So 2, 5 comes down. 2, 5 comes down. Correct? Again, double the quotient. What do you mean by double the quotient? It will be 28 into 2. Double the quotient. 28 into 2. What's 28 into 2? 56. Out here, 56. Now, whichever digit you place here, you must place the same digit here. Whatever digit you place here, you must place the same digit here. And this is the last stage in division, because we have no more pair which has to be brought down. So since this is the last pair and it's already come down, this is the last stage in the division process. And you see that this number ends with the digit 5. So it's very clear that you have to add a 5 here. You must place 5 here and place the same digit 5 here. Because only 5 5s can give you a 5 in the end. See, if you place 1 here, 1 into 1 is 1. I must tell you this, since this is the last step, you must get exactly 2825 as a product. Since this is the last stage in division, the product should be exactly equal to 2825, that is 2825. And when will you get a 5 in the ones place? Only when it is 5 5s are 25. Because if you place 1 here, 1 into 1 will give you 1 here. If it's 2, 2 into 2, 4. If you place 3 here, 3 into 3 is 9. But you need to get 5 in the ones digit. So you have to use a 5. Let's check the product. So if you place a 5 here, you must place the same digit here. And the product will be 565 into 5. What is it? 525, 2 carried over, 32, 3 carried over, 28. See that? So 5 here and a 5 here. So 565 into 5 is 2825. And the remainder should be 0. If the number is a perfect square, the remainder will be 0. Should be a 0. So what's the conclusion? The square root of 81,225 is 285. Whatever is the quotient is the square root. The remainder must be 0 if this number is a perfect square. This number is